I'm Sophie Compton.
My name is Reuben Hamlyn, and we are the directors of Another Body.
Guys, it is fantastic to have you here for us tonight at the British Independent Film Awards. Can you start with the basics? Can you tell us a little bit about your film and why it was an important story for you to bring to screen?
So Another Body follows the story of a college student who discovers one day that someone has made and distributed deepfake pornography of her. And after this discovery, we follow her as she tries to like hunt down the person who did it to him and pursue some form of justice in a legal context where there just aren't provisions for targets of this form of abuse. It's a really important story for us because women aren't protected online. Women are being harassed on a daily basis. Deepfake pornography is just one form of that harassment. And our film is kind of a, really brings to light quite the extent of the horrors that women can experience so that we can try and change the way the internet works, change the digital landscape so that people can participate freely online without fear of being harassed or abused.
Can you talk a little bit about the unique challenges and rewards of dealing with this sensitive type of subject matter?
Yeah. Well, I mean, one of the challenges is that you know that you're going after communities that are known for retaliation, for harassment, for abuse. So we decided to make our contributor anonymous. So we actually reclaim deepfake technology and use it to deepfake our main contributors throughout the film. And that was a challenge because it had never been done before. And we, you know, to really anonymize someone, which we knew was so important, and we've experienced why that is. You know, we've been targeted by 4chan, you know, having made this film, and but to actually do that was this huge feat of using new talent, new technologies, new ways. We used 3D animation, we used 2D animation, and yeah, we had to kind of build this entire world around the contributor to protect her.
Some of the communities that you're describing there, you know, defend this type of technology, particularly when it comes to deepfake pornography, and they say it's not real, it's not hurting anyone. Can you talk a little bit about how this film addresses that particular narrative, that particular viewpoint on this technology?
Absolutely. I mean, the film shows that this is a violation that is experienced as a form of sexual abuse. It's digital, but the effects are so real, are so tangible, and that minimization is unfortunately a narrative that is forged on these forums, but is accepted by the police, by the law, by the court. You know, there are no laws in most of the world against this. And when most women experience it and they go to the police say, what did you do to bring this upon yourself? The level of victim blaming and minimization is extraordinary. And I think, I really hope that no one, having watched our film, could come away with the idea that this is not a big deal. And I think that, you know, it impacts on a personal level, like vastly, but the societal impact of all of these women being silenced is so enormous and so intangible. We just cannot accept a future where women have to take themselves offline in order to protect themselves. What we really want to focus on, like, yes, we do believe that there needs to be criminal penalties for distributing deepfake content, because we think that that will help us set a new cultural standard, which will stop the normalization of this culture. Like, deepfake porn websites are growing exponentially. The biggest are getting 14 million hits a month. And so people might not even realize that what they're engaging and participating is a form of abuse. But we also really particularly want to target the tech companies and the kind of internet architecture that are the gatekeepers to these sites. So Google is basically funneling viewers to these sites. Internet service providers are hosting them. Social media companies need to address them as well. So there's a lot that we can do to get the sites that are dedicated to this abuse, dedicated to violating consent, off mainstream internet.